In this lesson, we'll explore the access control and the access control mechanism. Especially, we'll focus on access control fundamentals. So, let's go. First of all, we have to define what is access. So, access is the flow of information or the transformation of information between a subject. Here is the subject. And object, here is the object. So the flow of information between subjects such as users or user, programs, computer, or a device, or even running process is a subject. And the object, an example of objects are printer, computer, documents, files, especially the file. And here is a user. So the flow of information from the subject to the object is called as access. So we'll go to the next slide. Now we'll explain what is access control. Access controls are a collection of mechanisms that work together to protect the information of the information assets of the organizations. From unauthorized access, which is confidentiality, modification, which is the integrity, and disruption, which is availability. So simply, the access controls is a layer in between the users or malicious users, and here are the users, or here is the user, and a protected system. The types of access controls, or main types of access controls, are physical access, logical, technical access, and administrative access. And there are so many categories. We'll explain that in next lessons. So what is physical access? Physical access are facilities, equipment, and devices. And here you can find so many examples, such as science, fences, fire, gates, bollards, and other examples. So the next one is logical or technical access, which limits access to software and data. Here are the other examples. Passwords is an example of logical access. CCTV, IBS, IDS, connection control, audit logs, and etc. The next one is administrative access, which limits to policies, rules, law, security awareness, and job rotation. Here you can find DRP, data recovery policy. Or data recovery plan, not policy, report reviews, policy, job rotation, user registration procedure, employment or employee termination. Another definition is access control is a way to discover who is accessing the information. We can see here that the subject is accessing the information, and what is being accessed is the object, and how might the access occur. How subject is accessing the object, or how who access the what. As you can see here, this is the reference monitor. We can set here the rights and permissions. You can set here the rules. The audit logs can be here. So again, subjects are requests access to an object, which is an active entity, which is represented by who. The example of subject is user, program, process, or devices. Can be labeled as unclassified, secret, and top secret. Object can provide the requested access, which is a passive entity. You can represent it by what, and we saw that in the previous slide, who is the subject and what is the object. An example or examples here, file, you can represent it by file if you want to, just to understand it, just represent it, represent the subject by user and object by file. And here are the same sensitivity levels, or access sensitivity levels, unclassified, secret, and top secret. If the subject wants to access the object, it will go to the rights first, see what are the rights and how the rights and the permissions will illustrate how the subject can access the object, and we'll see this in more details here by giving the definition and example of the permissions. So many people are mixing between permissions and rights, so we'll see here what is permissions or and what are the rights, when to say permission and when to say rights. Access granted to subject, access granted to subject for an object, and determine what can you do with it, means with the object. The permissions are tagged to objects. These are the permissions here in Windows. These are full access, modify, read, and execute, here read and write. These permissions are tagged to objects. It means that we can give these permissions or set these configuration inside the folder. Whenever you click right click in Windows, in any Windows, for permissions, okay, then you will get, you will go to security, you will get this small window regarding the permission. Now the right is tagged to subject, means to the user, at the user side, okay. Rights are tagged to the users, and permissions are tagged to the objects. Okay, here in GB edit or local group policy editor in Windows, you can find these rights. You can see one example, remove the desktop, clean up wizard, reset. Yes here it will give a right for removing the desktop cleanup wizard. Remove a computer icon on the desktop. Here the user will not get this right if you select no. If yes, then you'll be able to remove computer icon on desktop. So what is right? Right is the ability to take an action on an object and don't include the access. Example is installing software, system login. You can find this in Windows. Whenever you log in, you will get a username, and you will enter the password. Then you will be able to log in. This is a right, not a permission. So backing up is a right. Adding or removing device driver. The rights are managed by user right policy, and we saw it here. You can get this right policy or local group policy editor by gbedit.msc in Windows. So we are now able to differentiate between right and permission. Now let's go to privileges. We know that we have admin privilege, root privilege, admin privilege in Windows, and super user. This can be explained by a super user whenever you right click on a command prompt here and run as administrator, will be able to run this command or run this command prompt using administrative privileges. So here an example in Ubuntu, whenever you issue this command, okay, without sudo, you will get this error, which is saying that this command is requiring a privilege or a super user privilege. So here, if you put sudo, okay, if you add sudo, then the command, it will ask for the root password, then you'll get the execution of this command as shown here. Now let's go to rules or roles. It's not rules. Rules is like this. Roles. Let's go back to privileges. It's a combination of rights and permissions. Combination of rights and permissions is known as privilege. Now let's go to rules or roles. Describe sets of privileges. Set of privileges. Okay. Based on job tasks. So roles are based on job tasks or other organizational artifacts. In this example here, if you want to select manage role by user, here you will select the user. Now by role, so the role here, administrative role, and the user here the role here, administrators. Who are the administrators? So we'll get the users who are administrators. And this, in this example, the only user who has administrative privileges is Tito. So the roles are based on job tasks. Now, let's go to default deny, which means any access or action not explicitly allowed is forbidden. So by default here in this firewall rule, by default, there is a deny. It means that deny everything except the source ID, any from the network to the destination IP on boards to 192.168.0.10. Here is the board is allowed. Okay, for TCP and UDP. Okay, and then everything is denied. Let's go to the default allow. Everything is allowed unless you deny it. So means any access or action not explicitly forbidden is allowed. Everything by default is allowed. Default is allowed. Here we denied something. We denied the destination from any inside the network to this destination port is denied. And everything is allowed. In next lesson, we'll go to need to know, least privilege, authorization creep, access privileges, separation of duties, and dual control. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope this information are useful for you. Thank you.